graders. It's Mrs. Heffa. We get to edit our paper today. Yay! And before we get started, I do have to say you guys are amazing. I am so proud of you. It is so hard to do this and to make sure to make time to get on and watch your writing video and then to follow it. And I'm so proud of you for doing that. And thank you so much for finishing your writing and typing it up and sending it to your teachers, because it is something that we're going to use on your report cards when we work on them in November. So it's really important that we get those typed final copies. Before we send this one, though, we're going to edit it a little bit first, okay? So I want you to remember from last time, I had that awful red pencil that kept breaking. I have a new one. So I'm really hoping...
Don't break on me.
I'm really hoping it doesn't break. Okay, so when we edit in class, usually we use a red pencil or marker. That way we can see where we're editing things. We revised last time with either a blue or purple one. You guys have colored pencils in your supply bins, so colored pencils work great. Remember when we edit, I wanted to pull this out from last time we talked about it. When we edit with our eyes. We've already reread when we were revising and checked everything out, and we're pretty sure that we like what we hear. Now we're just going to look through with our eyes, and we're going to check for capitals, making sure our sentences begin with capitals. If we have the name of our inventor, there are capitals at the beginning of their first and last name on your author line. You could write it on your paper to remind your brain, my name should have a capital at the beginning and at the beginning of my first name and my last name. Usage, remember that means correct nouns and verbs. So we don't say, and then he runned home. We say, and then he ran home, okay? Punctuation, we're looking for sentence endings, question marks, exclamation points, or periods in the appropriate spots. We probably don't need to worry about dialogue because we're writing nonfiction right now and we are not really talking about people having conversations with each other. We're talking about this invention. And then we're also going to look for spelling. If something doesn't look right, we're going to circle it and we're going to kind of keep looking for it for answers. Now, I will tell you, I was supposed to go back and I was supposed to find Edison and Howard's first names, and you guys, I didn't. So, Mrs. Heffa is actually going to circle it as an editing thing, and so that I know that I need to go back and I need to find it, because that is like super important, because it sounds really weird in the writing when I just talk about Howard and Edison. Like, you guys know, I mean, I'm sure you know Edison, but like, you guys know Howard. Probably not. So I am going to show you my writing now, and I have a few things that we're going to go through. So I'm just going to scan my writing, and I'll talk out loud while I'm scanning. I'm scanning for these things, okay? So I'm just going to go through and do like Christmas lights. I do. Okay, so this should be a capital L. And remember, we want it to be capital. You could also do lines. When I was in school, we did these three lines under letters that should be capitals, like I talked about last time, and that meant that your letter should spring up into a capital. At least that's how I always remembered it. Let me tell you all about how Albert Sadaka, yep, capitals, invented them. The first strand of lights was not made by Albert Edison. I'm going to circle it because, guys, I got to find their first names. Remember. And Howard were actually the first inventors to string lights together. Oh, punctuation, I started a new sentence. But they only made a few. I'm just kind of going through and looking for anything. Maybe I want to double check the word expensive. So I'm going to circle it. I'm going to put SP for spelling with a question mark. And that just means I want to check the spelling when I type it. If you notice when you type, there are little squiggly lines under words that may not be spelled correctly. And if you click on them, sometimes it gives you spelling hints. Sometimes they're wrong. But sometimes they're right and they can be helpful. And we'll talk about that when we start typing next time. Yep. I'm seeing capitals at the beginning. I'm seeing punctuation at the end. There are names. Oh, Christmas, by the way, is an actual holiday. So it gets a capital. Any holiday, that official name gets a capital. He also thought that if his family made the lights, then they would make a lot of money. Oh, capital on Albert. I'm going to spring that up. It's his name, so it should be a capital, and it's the beginning of the sentence, so it definitely has to be a capital. Started the NOMA, because this is the NOMA company. NOMA is on in all capitals. I'm not sure if it's the NOMA electrical company or if the company just goes by NOMA. I don't know. So I am going to circle it, and I am going to put these three lines with a question mark because I am not sure if their name is just NOMA or if their name is NOMA Electrical Company. Because if it is, then electrical and company should have a capital at the beginning because they're part of the official name. I'll look it up. A little bit of Google never hurt me. I'll Google it. Okay, so you're very popular. Popular. Pretty sure that's how you spell popular. Maybe I'll put a little circle around it because I'm wondering. Maybe. I don't know. It never hurts to check. Now you know how my Christmas lights are invented. You also know why Albert Chicago is an important inventor. I like it. I went through pretty quick on mine. I know you'll probably look at yours a little bit more closely. That's our only job today, although I do know that some of you get really excited about the typing part. So if you jump on and start a new Google Doc and start typing, I won't tell. And then next time, if you haven't, next time we will start typing and I will help you remember how to start that document and how to tab in your paragraphs and how to hit enter to the next line instead of hitting the space bar a bunch of times. Don't do that. It will drive your teacher crazy. We sit there and we're like, why did they do that? Don't do it. Okay, guys, have fun editing. Editing! We're almost ready for typing. Yay! And then you guys, by the end of this week, you will have another final paper. You will have been in school like a month, remote learning for a month, and you will have written two papers already. You guys are amazing. Have fun editing. I'll see you next time. Don't lose your paper. Put it in your folder. Okay, bye.